Okay, let's start with this guy right here in the foreground, Mr. Group 2. One thing that can help with compositing people is putting a adjustment layer that is black and white. And that just turns our whole scene black and white, and we see the tone of the people to see if they kind of fit. This guy's got a dark shirt on, but generally he looks pretty close to where he needs to be. And we can just start putting... Oh, one cool thing about this guy is I turned this layer into a smart object by convert to smart object. And what that does is when you put a filter on it, it creates a smart filter. So Homie can actually be blurred and unblurred just by turning off that smart filter. And he can be masked out. So this is one cool thing about blurring, is if you blur the whole object but you realize like some parts would be moving faster than others, then you can just do this and paint out the parts that you don't want to blur much. Like that. If you use a smart filter. And again, you do that by just taking the guy, right clicking on him, saying convert to smart filter or smart object, and then every filter you put on it will be a smart filter that can be masked out or turned on and off. Okay, but let's get back to the coloring. Here's a levels adjustment for the guy. Obviously that one is too dramatic. We want him to be maybe there. And just make sure it looks right for the scene that he's standing in. Remember, that's a light concrete that he's standing on. His shirt is black, his hair is black. So that looks like it might be about right. Yeah, he needs his coloring adjusted quite a bit though. So here's a hue saturation layer. Let's turn it on. This does a good job of turning his saturation down, so we're not seeing so much of his skin color because he's really just going to be washed with a cool light. So let's turn him down saturation wise. Okay, I want to do a color balance on him too. Layer, new adjustment, color balance. And let's make sure that his shadows especially are bluish. Not so much cyan there, right around there. And his highlights can have a little bit of red in them. Okay, and now for the final aspect of getting this guy in here, let's add some lighting to him. And we do that, I do that again with overlays. So I just create a new layer that's applying only to the guy, you know, like this, only to the guy. And we take some things and we add some light to him. I guess it could be called rim light in this case. Take it and get a nice soft brush and start painting. So all his arm hairs and stuff are going to be showing that green light from the bus there. His hair on top of his head. His shoulder will be catching some reflection from that. And maybe from up here too, right? And we're only applying it to the guy, so it doesn't really matter how or where you're painting. Everything is only going to be applied to the dude. You can paint outside the lines in this case, I should say. Okay, so this bike fender here would be catching reflections from those windows over there and all that fun stuff. Okay, so we're just painting it on normal mode, but we put it to overlay to make it less dramatic. Okay, but it's still catching some of that light. So now he's really fitting into that scene there. This guy clearly needs some contact shadow down here and some nice soft shadow because he's not in direct light. So keep that in mind. And really, I mean, you can see that the trick to this is just probably just looking at source photography and seeing how some, you know, how a person would look, their blur, how they're going to catch the light, all that kind of stuff in this particular situation, and then adapting your particular image of a person to composite nicely into your scene. So a lot of it is just looking at it and being an artist, using your creativity and using your ability to perceive light and imitate light properly with your illustration. Okay, so what I'm doing is painting black in right wherever his foot touches the ground, and the bike wheels as well, and I'm just painting in and then blurring for shadow. Okay, we can put that on multiply. Okay, there's his contact shadows. And then, so if you observe someone standing on concrete somewhere, you'll see that all around like the bottom of their shoe and right up close to where they're making contact with the object below them, there will be a dark and sort of crisper shadow, you know, these kind of shadows. In this case, they'll be blurred a little bit. So, okay, and then as it goes away from him, and we know this from doing 3D art, as it goes away from him, it'll become a much softer shadow. And instead of black, maybe we could go this deep, deep blue. So all around him is going to be this kind of softness. Let's actually do that on a new layer. That looked really good, though. So let's try to do it just as well, but on a different layer. Okay, let's put that to multiply. Turn down the opacity some. So it's very soft. Okay, and maybe you get some reflection from that bike going on, right? Maybe we can just take this guy, jump him to a new layer, and then Control T to transform him. Flip him vertically. Accept that transform. And put him down here. And then maybe blur him again in that direction, up and down. Something like that. And then maybe put him to overlay. No, maybe. Multiply? No. Put him on normal and then turn him down. Way down. Subtle, subtle, subtle. Okay, subtle is the name of the game here. Okay, he's looking all right. I don't like how saturated he is. Like his skin color is too vivid for being... Oh man, what we did here is we applied all these adjustment layers to the wrong layer. That's why it's wrong. We want these up here, not applied to the reflection, but applied to the actual dude. Now he's looking right. Okay, so reflection. The only thing I don't like is how bright that wheel is down there, and maybe how bright that fender is. The guy himself looks good. Bike, not so much. Okay, so I'll go in and adjust a few more things here. Make it apply only to the guy. And I want to turn down overall like that. Turn down the guy overall like that, and then let's do another one where we turn down even more and apply it just to the bike area. So I inverted the mask, and I'm just painting back into. Okay, so this guy, not a lot of light being caught over here, so we'll turn him down more on this side of his body. Okay, there he is. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, so that's a full compositing of a dude into your scene. Go through and do the rest of these. I will do that offline, put some more of these people in, and then we'll move on to the finishing touches for our rendering, and we'll be pretty much done.